In this video, you will learn about multiverse optimization algorithm. This algorithm is inspired by multiverse theory. Certain topics are covered in this video. First, we will start with introduction. That is basic introduction about our planet. Then, what is multiverse theory? Next is multiverse optimization algorithm. What is roulette wheel mechanism? And why we are using this in the multiverse optimization algorithm? And numerical example for this algorithm and how we can create black hole and white hole and their mathematical model and how we can exchange objects in between different universes and how we can create the tunnel for the object transportation, and we will display the final output. So let's start this with simple introduction. As we all know, we are in the space. And in the space, we are living on planet Earth. And Earth is in the solar system. And our solar system is in the Milky Way galaxy. Suppose here. And you can see here, we have a number of universes. So you can see here, according to multiverse theory, we have multiple universes. And this algorithm is inspired by multiverse theory. Multiverse means a group of multiple universes, and according to this theory, there are more than one Big Bang, and each Big Bang caused birth of a universe. So what is Big Bang theory? According to Big Bang theory, our universe started with a massive explosion, and before this explosion, nothing exists in this world. And our universe came into existence 13 billion years ago from a single hot dense point. So universe come into existence from a massive explosion, because you can see here in our universe we have time, space, planet, galaxy, star, energy and matter. So according to multiverse theory, we have more than one Big Bang, and each Big Bang caused the birth of a universe. One Big Bang means one universe, two Big Bang means two universe. So we have a number of Big Bang, that is more than one. It means we have n number of universes according to multiverse theory. In this algorithm, that is in multiverse optimization algorithm, three main concepts from multiverse theory are used. That is white hole, or we can say Big Bang, black hole and wormhole. According to multiverse theory, white hole or Big Bang are created where collision between parallel universe occurred, and black hole can attract everything including light with their higher gravitational force, and wormhole act as travel tunnel where objects can travel from one universe to another. So we have three main concepts from multiverse theory that are used in this algorithm. In multiverse optimization algorithm, universes interact with each other by white hole, black hole and wormhole to reach a stable state. So this is the main inspiration for this algorithm. During optimization in this algorithm, certain rules are applied that we will cover in the numerical section. Now we have roulette wheel mechanism. You can see this is roulette wheel table. Roulette is a casino game, that is the game of chance. And here on this table, you can see we have 37 numbers from 0 to 36. 0 is colored with green and other color with 18 black, 18 red. And we have, you can see a ball. In this game, you will select a number, and if ball stop on the selected number, then you win, else you lose. In this algorithm, we are using the roulette wheel mechanism for white hole and black hole tunnel and to exchange objects between different universes. So with the help of roulette wheel, we can choose one universe among all for white hole. How? At each iteration, we will sort universe according to their inflation rate, that is the fitness value. So at each iteration, you will sort universe according to their fitness value and select one using roulette wheel. According to multiverse theory, we have more than one universe, and you can see here D is the total number of variable, or you can say parameter, N is the total number of universes, and this is the mathematical model that we can use for the selection of one universe for white hole. Here this is the jth parameter of kth universe, this is the jth parameter of ith universe, and here this is the ith universe, and R1 is the random value in between 0 and 1. Using this mechanism, universe can exchange object with each other without any disorganization. Now, how universe exchange objects in this algorithm? So we are using the concept of wormhole in this algorithm for object exchange in between different universes. So wormhole acts as a tunnel in between white hole and black hole. So for simplicity, it is assumed that wormhole tunnel are always established between a universe and best universe created. Here this is the mathematical model they can use for object exchange in different universes. Here this is the jth variable of fittest universe created, and this is the jth parameter of ith universe. Here R2, R4, R3, they are the random values in between 0 and 1. WEP is the wormhole existence probability. TDR means traveling distance rate. Upper bound means maximum limit. Lower bound means minimum limit. And we can compute the value for TDR and WEP using these equations. Here P is the exploration accuracy. If value for P is higher, it means you got accurate local search. Here small l is the current iteration and capital L is the maximum iteration. So this is simple multiverse optimization algorithm. Input for this algorithm is population size and the maximum number of iteration, and output is display vast universe and its fitness value, or you can say inflation rate. In step 1, we will initialize all the important parameter, and then we will compute the fitness value for each universe and select best universe. After that, for each universe, we will update the white hole existence probability and traveling distance rate, and then we will select one universe among n white hole left field mechanism. And after that, in step 5, use wormhole as tunnel for object exchange between different universe, and we will repeat this loop until the stopping criteria is matched. Here stopping criteria means current iteration. We will check current iteration and maximum number of iteration. When current iteration is equal to or greater than maximum number of iteration, that is the stopping criteria, and in the end display the vast universe. So in the step 1, we will initialize all the important parameter. Here you can see population size, random numbers and all. So this is the initial population for 4 universe. Suppose we have population size 4. This is the population size or initial position for n universes, and n is here 4. In step 2, we will compute the fitness value for each universe. So using a fitness function, we will compute the fitness value for each universe, and you can see fitness value is computed for each universe using a fitness function. And after that, we will select the best universe. Here minimum value is considered as best, and you can see universe 1 has value 3.8063. So this is the best universe. And now we have initial population, you can see, and the best universe, that is number 1, and we have all the fitness values for each universe. Now in step 3, we will update the values for WEP and traveling distance rate. In step 4, we will select one universe among n by using the left field selection mechanism as a white hole. Now we are going to create a white hole and black hole. So now we will create white hole. So this is the mathematical model. Here I'm using three random values, R1, R2, R3. Here you can see value for R1 is 0.8558. So you can use this. So this is just the random value we selected here. So you can see here we have certain rules applied in this algorithm. If fitness value is higher, it means we have higher probability of having a white hole and lower probability of having a black hole. And universes with higher fitness value will send objects through white hole, and universes with lower fitness value will receive more objects through black hole. And according to rule number 5, the objects in all universe may face random movement toward best universe by bomb hole. So here you can see universe with higher inflation rate considered to have white hole, and universes with lower inflation rate considered to have black hole. So you can see here universe with the higher fitness value, or you can say the inflation rate, is considered to have white hole and they have black hole. And at each iteration you will sort universe according to their fitness value. And here we are using quick sort. You can see we have 1, 3, and 4. Universe has black hole and second universe has white hole. Now you can see we have white hole and black hole. Using white hole we can send, and using black hole we can receive. So white hole is here as sender and black hole is receiver. So we need something. Suppose we have home bun in city X and online it ordered any parcel from any store that is located in city Y. So here this store that is located in city Y can use any transportation medium, any vehicle, railway, air freight, for the parcel transportation from city Y to city X. Now we have white hole in black hole. Using white hole we can send and black hole can receive. Now we need transportation medium to exchange objects between universe. So we are using here tunnel. Using this we can exchange objects between different universes. So here we have now transportation medium, that is wormhole. Now in step 5, use wormhole as a tunnel for object exchange between different universes. And this is the mathematical model. Now we can use wormhole as a tunnel for exchange objects between different universes, and wormhole act as time or space travel tunnel in between different universes. Now you use wormhole as a tunnel for object exchange between different universes. You can see the mathematical model here. If R2 is less than WEP, then this one, else this one. Here you can see best universe plus traveling distance rate into upper bound minus lower bound into random value plus the lower bound, and the best universe formed. For simplicity, it is assumed that wormhole tunnels are always established between universe and the best universe formed. Suppose this is the best universe and here we have other universe. This universe has higher fitness value, so it can send, and here we have lower fitness value, it can receive. So we will check the current iteration and the maximum iteration, and we will repeat the loop until stopping criteria is matched, and after that in the end we will display the best universe. A fitness function is used here. You can see here the best optimum value we got for this is 0.00492, and another function is also tested and we got 0.39789. So that's all about this algorithm. First we will initialize all the important parameter. Initialize the population for n search agents. After that we will compute the fitness value for each and we will select the best, and minimum value is considered as best. Then we will update the white hole existence probability and traveling distance rate for each universe, and then we will select one among n as white hole, and then we will use wormhole as a tunnel for object exchange between different universes, and we will repeat this until the stopping criteria is matched and in the end display best universe. So that's all about this video. All the important resources are given below in the description box, and if you have any question you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.